Shem Kevo Ma'uto Le'olam Vayet. Hear, O Israel, the Lord Ayah, the Lord is one. Blessed be the name of his glorious kingdom forever and ever. All praises to the Most High Yah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. On the third day. We get up this morning seeking him first, the kingdom of the Most High Yah, and all his righteousness, knowing that all things shall be added unto us. Therefore, we come seeking, knocking, and asking, because we know right now we are on the heels of Hanukkah. Today is December the 1st, if you can believe that or not. Today is December the 1st. And Hanukkah begins on December the 11th through December the 18th. Come on now. Yahushua is the light of the world. And guess what? You got just enough oil. As we continue to walk through this pandemic, as we continue to walk through the things that are going on in this modern day Babylon, you have just enough oil. So come on, don't you get weary in well-doing, because you're going to reap this harvest if you faint not. Don't get weary in well-doing, because you're going to reap this harvest if you faint not. We have to press now. And I mean press like never before. Press through our imaginations, our thoughts, our mindsets. We have to cast down vain imaginations that exalt itself against the knowledge of the Most High Yah. That comes with all these series that we've been teaching on. Understanding kingdom philosophy. Understanding the keys of the kingdom. Come on now. We've been getting some awesome teachings from the Most High Yah. I'm talking about knowledge, understanding, and wisdom. But we have to make the application. It's all on us. The Most High Yah can keep feeding you and feeding you and feeding you. But until you decide, this is my lifestyle, and this is the way I want to change, I want a conversion, I want to walk out the principles of the Most High Yah. Until you make up your mind to apply it to your life, nothing will change. Sometimes we sit around and we say, things just seem the same, or that thing seems like they're getting worse. No, you're not applying the principles to your life. Remember right now, the Most High Yah has us on, you know, self-control. Are you really controlling yourself? Because it's going to take some self-control. You're going to have to unlearn some things. Come on now. You know some things that we have been taught, we're going to have to unlearn them. And that takes self-control, because a lot of times we want to wrap our minds around what we were taught, how we were brought up, the things in our past. We want to try to, you know, walk in those things. And look, like, it's like these emotions that come up on the inside that's kind of familiar, because we've been conditioned. So when you walk through certain kind of conditions, and now the Most High Yah, through his commandments, are showing you a different lifestyle, you're so conditioned, you don't know how to shift your mind. You're always thinking the way that you think you should think. So because of your conditioning, you don't know how to shift your mind. Because see, you're going to have to come out of a religious mindset. The kingdom of the Most High Yah is not about religion. Yeah. So you're going to have to come out of a religious mindset. We've been conditioned. You know, sometimes you think to yourself, that's what I thought. You ever say that to yourself? You be doing some things and you make decisions, you make choices, you like, well, that's what I thought. And I mean, that's the way I've always done things. But the Most High Yah is saying, oh no, you have to not lean to your own understanding. You're going to have to cast down vain imaginations. My thoughts are not your thoughts. As high as the heaven is high, they're higher than yours. So it's not about what you think. It's about what you apply. Now, that's what we have to come to an understanding for real. Because, you know, we can think about some things, and we'll make a decision or a choice based off of our thoughts. Instead of taking the principles of the Most High Yah and applying them to our lives. It has to be an application. I don't care what you say. You have to apply the word to your life in order for it to work. Or else you're just sitting on all these principles and you're doing nothing with them and you're wondering why your life is not changing. Come on, be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind. Be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind. That's the only way we're going to get it. Seriously, that's the only way we're going to get it. We have to have a mind change. Yes. Good morning, Boker Toe, Queen Gina, Queen Carol, bless you, Queens. You know, we have to have a made-up mind. Folks say, when you make up your mind, nothing is impossible. You have to make up your mind. You know, we can sit in things and sit in things and sit in things, and until we have a mind shift, nothing changes in our lives. I was told a made-up mind is dangerous. You know what? You could be like going through something, and you just keep going through it until one day you get up and you be like, there's no more. This is not going to happen no more. I am done with this. I have made up my mind to operate differently. And then all of a sudden, folks is like, you know, they try them same things on you, those same tricks, and they be like this. Oh, that ain't working no more. Oh, you didn't know. I made up my mind that I was not going to operate in being defeated in my life. I was not going to operate in just taking the okie doke. I was not going to operate in the lies and the deception and the manipulation. I was just going to walk out the principles of the Most High Yah. So therefore, a made up mind is a dangerous thing. Hasatan wants to keep you in darkness. And the Most High Yah is saying, come on out of darkness into my marvelous light. Come on out of darkness into my marvelous light. He wants to keep you with a mind that cannot change. He wants to keep you in your conditions, in your dysfunction. He wants to keep you there. So long as you are in a place where you can't move, you kind of stuck. Because when you don't make up your mind, you're stuck. You keep doing the same thing every day. You're just stuck and wondering why you're not growing. You got to change some things. You have to change some things in your life. And as soon as you change it, you'll see changes in your life. And I mean permanent changes. Because now you're walking in the Most High Yah's God-given authority. I mean, he has the power, but he has given you the authority. He has given you some keys, as we were taught on Sabbath. And if you missed that teaching, you need to go back and listen to it. He has given you some keys.
Yes.
Whatever you bind in the earth shall be bound in heaven. And whatever you loose in the earth shall be loosed in heaven. He's given you some keys. But what sense in having keys if you don't know how to use them? You got to know how to use the keys. And that takes wisdom. That takes application. That takes understanding, which is comprehension. And that takes you getting all the information that you can from the Most High Yah. Information is knowledge, and that is a key. And the Most High Yah says, my people are destroyed from lack of what? Knowledge. Knowledge is a key. So therefore, he has given you these keys. You need to learn the keys of the kingdom, because that's what you have, the keys of the kingdom, not to the kingdom, but of the kingdom. Once you learn that, oh my goodness, Hasatan is going to be like, oh my goodness, the dangerous, dangerous, dangerous. And so we want to walk in authority. Because we're queens and kings in this earth realm. We might be in this world, but we're not of this world. So we want to walk in some kingdom authority. Come on in here, Queen Regina, this morning. I love you, beautiful one. We want to walk in that authority. You know, sometimes in life we just want to change. And it's time for change. We're on the heels of a new year. And I'm not talking about January. I'm talking about March. When the children of Israel came out of Egypt, that was the new year. So therefore, we're on the hill of a new year, 5781. 5781. I'm excited. I'm in expectation because I know the Most High Yah has kept us during this pandemic. And right now, these coronavirus cases are rising every single day. Every single day. People are dying every single day. One of my parents who is a nurse right here in Colorado, she says, in 12 days, just watch, Miss J, there's going to be an explosion. So we need to be careful. We need to be wise. We need to be doing what we can to walk in wisdom during this time. I know we got the blood on the doorpost, but you're going to still have to walk in obedience. Amen. Don't be thinking you like, oh, I could just go out here and do whatever I want to do. No, you can't go out here and do whatever you want to do. Hmm. You got to use wisdom. And I'm praying for you every day, Queen Regina, as you walk through the halls of those nursing of that nursing home. Because I know right now it cannot be easy. And now they're saying all the health workers are getting sick. Nurses and doctors are getting sick. There are no beds in Colorado. I don't know where you're going to go. There are no beds in Colorado. Just know that. So that's the key right there that I gave you. You might want to use some wisdom when it comes to your health and COVID. Because all those pastors remember that said, oh no, I got the faith of Jesus. Mm-mm. And they went to them churches anyway on Sunday and every last one of them dead.
Oh Lord.
The bishops, their wives, the pastors, all of them, gone. So the Most High Yah is telling us in this season to use wisdom and be obedient and practice self-control. Seriously, practice self-control until he says stop, remember? So how y'all doing with that self-control thing? How y'all doing? How y'all doing? Are y'all casting down vain imaginations when those imaginations come up? When folks are provoking you, are you being still and knowing that he is the Most High Yah? Mm-hmm. Are you in your mind right now saying, woo, child! Mm. You better be glad I'm practicing self-control. Or else you get cussed out right now. Mm-hmm. So how y'all doing with that self-control? Mm. Yeah, it's not easy. Because you got to come out of your conditions. It's not easy because it's what you're used to, what you're familiar with, how you respond. Hmm. Do you know that everything does not cause for your response? You ain't got to respond to folks. What you say, Queen Regina? Yes, ma'am. Employees and residents of our assisted living has gotten it. Well, I'm so glad the Most High Yah is keeping you. I'm so glad the Most High Yah is keeping you. And then this coronavirus is so unpredictable, right? You know, my son tested positive. And so he did his 14 days and then he did 10 more days, right? I feel like he did, I don't know. But so he had to go get tested again yesterday before he's allowed to go back to work. And so when he went and got tested, he tested positive for COVID again. I'm like, wait a minute now. Yes, you are, Queen. You are so blessed. He tested positive again. So what I do, I call my parent, that's the nurse, and I'm like, hey, Angie, now how could this be? He tested negative. I want y'all to get this first. He tested negative first, so he thought he was good. But 3 to 4 days later, he started with these symptoms, the fever and all this kind of stuff. So then after that, he went and got tested again, tested positive this time, because now he got the symptoms. So just because you test negative, I need y'all to get this, because this is very important. This is a key of knowledge that I'm giving you about this COVID. You can test negative and think you're good. And 3 to 4 days later, you start having symptoms. Is that my brother up in here? Kenny. I love you, Kenny. I so love you. I do. So he tested positive 4 days later. So that's the reason why this thing is so dangerous and it can spread so fast, because you can test negative and think you're good. 3 days later, you're positive. So then after he went through his 14 days, 10 days quarantine, went through all the symptoms, and so he goes to take the test again yesterday, and he's positive. I'm like, how can that be? So, of course, I called up my nurse, my parent, that is a nurse, and said, hey, you know, Trey tested positive again for COVID. She said, oh, yeah, it can stay. You can test positive after you have no symptoms up to 3 weeks later. I said, excuse me? Yeah, you can test positive up to 3 weeks later. The virus is still in your body. You're just not symptomatic. What'd that mean? Hmm. She's like, oh, as long as he don't have no symptoms, no fever or anything like that, he should be allowed to go back to work. I'm like, I'm like, is this how this thing just keep on spreading? Because you think you good, but you not, and you still positive. But she said, we even stopped testing people again because they're going to test positive for a minute. So I was like, oh, no. What? But you can also be asymptomatic. My mom tested positive, but praise the Most High, she's doing fine, no symptoms. See, this is what I'm talking about. This COVID, man, it's so unpredictable. That's why you just need to lock yourself inside if you're able to. Stay at home. Stay at home. Oh, we test twice a week. Oh, that's good. That is very good that you guys test twice a week. Ooh, because Queen, I be, you know, he ain't give a spirit of fear. I'm not in fear about you being up in there. I just be concerned. I be real concerned. So that's why I always keep you lifted in prayer, Queen Regina, with your beautiful smile. I know they need you up in there. I'm just saying. I need my sister to be all right. So I'm thanking the Most High Yah for what he's doing in our lives and how he continues to teach us and teach us wisdom. I mean, really to use wisdom. We are in a season of being wise. Come on now. We are on the heels of Hanukkah. Have you guys went out and got your, well, not go out. I don't mean it like that. Have you gone out online? The internet is your friend. Everything will come to your front door. You're not going anyway. Understand? You're not going anywhere. You're Miss Internet or Mr. Internet, and you order everything off the internet. So, like I said before, Amazon has menorahs that you can order. Pass me one of those. You can pass one from right back here. Or over there. That might be better for me. Amazon is selling menorahs, and they have some beautiful ones. I mean, pretty. I mean, I got like six of them. I think I need some more because I love the whole house to be lit up. I mean, lit up. So you want to go out and get your menorah. And it has the eight where you put your candles at for the 8 days, because remember the oil was only supposed to burn for 1 day. They only had enough oil for 1 day. But guess what? The Most High Yah, with men, things might be impossible. But with the Most High Yah, all things are possible, because guess what? It burned for 8 days. And so I'm going to do a teaching on Hanukkah. And I'm going to do a teaching on the menorah so you know what it means. This represents Yahuwah right here in the middle. And he lights all the candles. So get your menorah, because we're starting December the 11th through December the 18th. We're celebrating Hanukkah. And you give 8 gifts a night. Now, you ain't got to go out there and kill yourself. Huh?
1 gift per night.
Yeah, 8 gifts for the total of the 8 days. So 1 gift every night. And child, I was like, when I came and crossed over Hebraically and started doing Hanukkah, I was like, shoot, Hanukkah is way better than some Christmas. We wait for 1 day to get all these gifts on a pagan day. Folks be going broke, child. Hanukkah is like, girl, what you need? A Reese's candy bar, that's your favorite. I got you. I got you. So you give a gift every night. It's beautiful. And you say these prayers as you light the candles. So as we get closer to it, I'm going to teach on Hanukkah and teach on the menorah so you know exactly what you're doing and why. Because you didn't know why you was doing Christmas, did you? Because Jeremiah told you not to bring no tree in your house and don't decorate it, but you did it anyway. Why? Because grandmama did it. Handed down traditions of men. So we don't do traditions. We do the feast days of the Most High Yah. So walk in his feast days and not in these pagan holidays. We are not on the hills. It ain't no 24 days to Christmas. It's 10 days to Hanukkah. So we are the light of the world. He calls us the children of light. So I'm going to let you let your light so shine before men that they will know that you about Hanukkah and not Christmas. Mm-hmm. And we're going to do a teaching, Hanukkah versus Christmas. Ooh, and Santa Claus. All right. We're going to go into these pagan holidays and give you some understanding. Because it takes wisdom to move out of stuff. Mm-hmm. You know, it takes wisdom. You got to have the knowledge to know that's what's going on. Happy birthday, King Reynard. Belated birthday. I pray you had an awesome celebration, celebrating yourself. So happy birthday to you. So we're just going to walk in wisdom, period. You know, we ain't going to be foolish. We are not the foolish versions. We are the wise versions. And we're going to keep on walking in this kingdom in order to understand the Most High Yah's word is about the king and a kingdom. And he is king of what? Kings. That means we are kings and queens. We are heirs to the throne. We are children of the Most High Yah. But you have to get that understanding. You have to get that understanding. The word says, through all your getting, get an understanding. So I'm thankful, thankful, thankful. As we get ready to go into this teaching this morning, I'm just loving the Most High. I'm just loving him. You know, his feast days, you're going to have to be like Judah Maccabee. That's what Hanukkah is about. We will not assimilate. We will not. And we will not bow down to your little pagan gods. We're not doing that. Mm-mm. We're going to stand up like Judah Maccabee and whoop some. Fight. That's what I meant to say. We're going to stand up like Judah Maccabee and fight. So we're in that season of, you know, it's war time, y'all. It's war. Every time these feast days come around, get ready. And this one is really a war because you got to fight for the light, baby. You got to fight for the oil. So call Michael, because all you got to do is stand still and know that he is the Most High Yah. Call Michael to war right now. It's December the 1st, mm-hmm. and Hanukkah starts on December the 11th. You better be calling Michael to war, mm-hmm. and you better take a stand like Judah Maccabee, because if you don't stand for something, you're going to fall for everything. So take a stand, mm-hmm. period. I wish you would. Come over here with that Christmas tree if you want to. Mm-mm. But I will say, I'm not hard like I was in the beginning when I crossed over and I would see a tree and I'd probably rip it out your house. No, I'm playing. But I used to celebrate Christmas. I loved Christmas. You know what I'm saying? I did them pagan holidays. Shoot, I had the best color on Easter Sunday. You better know I was at sunrise service. Yes. I celebrate all them little pagan things, child. Valentine's Day, I wish you didn't. I buy me some doggone roses and candy. We would have some problems. You knew Valentine's Day come around every year. What you mean? Oh, the restaurants are all booked up, boo. What? You were supposed to make reservations back in September. A year before.
Oh, fuck.
So I celebrated all those pagan holidays. So don't beat folks up too bad because they're still ignorant. And ignorant is not a bad thing. Remember, the definition of ignorance is you just don't know. Mm-hmm. You don't know. So don't be too hard on folks that celebrate these pagan holidays. Because, child, I was, girl, soon as November, like Thanksgiving came or whatever, mm-hmm. shoot, the next day, Christmas tree going up. It was the biggest Christmas tree in the world. Folks would come to my house and be like this, your tree is bigger than Barack Obama's. How your tree bigger than the folks in the White House? Don't you worry about it. So I would have the biggest Christmas tree and I would put out all those things. And the day after Thanksgiving, I would put on all those Christmas songs. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. Oh, girl, I was all into that, child. I was a Christmas person, child. Have a little Santa Claus hat that I wear in a daycare for my kids. Oh, yeah, I was all into it. So I cannot, like, you know, kill people or murder them on Christmas. They got to come out of darkness, you know, into the Hanukkah lights.
Yeah.
You know, and light the menorah and know why and what we're doing, that it's about the Most High Yah's feast days. But y'all got to draw folks with loving kindness, because Dr. J didn't do that in the beginning. I was not drawing nobody with no loving kindness. You understand me? Because at the time I was in theology school with these pastors and bishops and archbishops and all these big, you know, the big boy club. I was in school with them. Uh-huh. And so crossing over Heath Brinkley, and I would go to school and I would be like, excuse me, do you know about Hanukkah? Oh, yeah, we know about Hanukkah. Why you don't celebrate it? Oh, because we just do Christmas. You know, traditions. We don't want to, you know, mess up people. People. You don't want to mess up people. Who are you to withhold the truth? Man, Pastor Moore, I still love him to this day. He's like, Dr. J, you better back up, little girl. You're standing too close, and you're going off right now. I was going off on all of them. The little rabbi that came to teach our class was like, Sister, shalom. Shalom, sister. Shalom. Shalom. I was going off on all them pastors, bishop. I didn't care. You know the truth, and you're not teaching it. So don't be like Dr. J. I was like a terrorist. I was a Hebrew terrorist. I even told them, you better be careful, because when you leave class tonight, all your cars are hot wired. I'm going to blow y'all all up. That was like, oh my gosh. Dr. J is out of her mind. So yeah, so after class, I was pulled to the side by the rabbi. He was like, sister, you got to come in peace. I was like, but they lying to the people. He said, sister, shalom. Sister, shalom. You have to come in peace. I said, Yahushua came with a sword. He said, sister, you have to come in peace. With love and kindness have I drawn them. I was like this. All right. I ain't going to cut nobody, but I'm close. So I had to calm down. So if your family is still doing Christmas, just tell them about Hanukkah. Be nice. Don't be like, I tell you what, that thing in your house is a curse. I'm taking you to Jeremiah. You can read it. It's a curse thing. Oh, I would love it. I would love tearing them down with them doggone word. I was like, yeah. And you know Sunday is pagan too, don't you, Pastor? They be like, sister, shalom, shalom, shalom. So y'all be nice to folks. Don't, you know, if they still doing Christmas. Because at one time, my house was always divided at the time. My husband would take and put all his Christmas mess up in this little front room. And then on the side room, it'd be all Hanukkah stuff. So I would have a Christmas Hanukkah battle. Like, you put up a Christmas tree, I'm putting up a menorah. You put up some lights, I'm going to put up my candles. You come on with it. You know, I was like that. You putting up that doggone, you know I don't celebrate no Christmas. So, with loving kindness, have I drawn you. So, we need to teach people. Look at Queen Erica. Hey, beautiful one. She said, I told my mom, it starts December the 11th. Through December the 18th. And I'm going to be teaching it. So maybe y'all can share the video with somebody so they can get an understanding. Because you need to know what you're doing and why. Because we've been doing some stuff and we didn't know why and we kept doing it. But here it is. All this is biblical and you got a problem. Oh, you Jewish? Oh, now see, them fighting words right there. Self-control, Dr. J. Okay. No, we're not Jewish. There's no such word as Jewish. They put an ish on the end. You might want to look that up. They invented themselves. Isn't that something to be a made up people? Jewish. No, we're not Jewish. We're being biblical correct by celebrating the feast days of the Most High Yah that's in the Bible. Thank you, Most High. Hallelujah. Thank you. They talking about he was born during this time. Oh, woo! Wow. You really make me. I gotta practice self-control. I thought I was okay. I'm so glad I'm in stay at home. I know how y'all shelter in place. Y'all. I'm staying home. I thought I was okay. Talking about he was born in a manger. Ooh. On December 25th. What Christ got to do with any muss?
Oh, Lord.
We're just bringing out the Christ in Christmas. Christ is not in Christmas, so how you gonna bring out Christ? You got the wrong Christ. So we need to get it together. So we're going to be teaching it. We're going to be teaching about Hanukkah. We're going to be teaching the correct way. Because you shall know the truth. And the truth shall make you free. Let's get free. Y'all got the date? December the 11th through December 18th. We're going to start kicking off Hanukkah.
and lighting the candles and saying the prayers and giving one gift every night of Hanukkah. Thank you, Most High Yah. You are the light of the world. Come on, Yahushua. You are the way, the truth, and the light. Mm-hmm. Shema, Israel. Come on, Queen Gina. Hear, listen, and obey. That just, some peace came over me when you said that, Queen Gina. Shema, Israel. Hear, listen, and obey. Woo, Most High. I come lifting up everyone on Facebook Live this morning. The ones that are listening live and the ones that will listen later. Let them know right now that you are the light of the world. And we are entering into Hanukkah, December the 11th through December the 18th. It's about your light. You said, let there be light, and there was light. So thank you right now that every dark area in our life is about to be lit up. Uriel, light it up. Bring us out of darkness into your marvelous light. Keep us like never before. Ooh, you are the light of the world. Let your teaching this morning begin to give us understanding. Let it give us wisdom. Let us have us to apply the word to our life. Let this teaching this morning resonate in our soul. Because you have given us an anchor for our soul. And that anchor grips the solid rock, and that rock is Yahuwah. I'm thanking you for your Holy Spirit, your Ruach HaKodesh, that's going to lead and guide us into all understanding as we begin to break up the fallow ground. Woo. And I will forever give you all the glory, all the honor, and all the praise. And it's in the mighty, mighty name of Yahushua, I pray. All praises to the Most High Yah. The word says, if two or three gather together in his name, that he would be in the midst. The word says, if two touch and agree on anything, it shall be done. And I know I can't do nothing this morning without this word being established through the law, the prophets, and the writings. So the method style of study, it is a process of studying the word of Ahayah, Asha Ahayah, which is I am that I am in Hebrew, the great I am, the Yah of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. And we seek his guidance and live in a kingdom lifestyle. The Torah is the Most High Yah's teachings and instructions in 613 principles. It's where the Creator speaks, Mother. And then we search the witnesses through the books of the prophets, the Nevi'ims, and the books of the writings, the Ketuvim. Collectively, the Torah, the Nevi'ims, and the Ketuvim, or identified as the Tanakh, which is the Old Testament's proper title. And it's the only book that Yahushua studied in reference throughout the New Testament. Isaiah chapter 43, verse 15. I am the Most High, your Holy One, the Creator of Israel, your King. Ooh. Today we look to the word King, Hebrews number 4427, Malak, terrain, inceptively, to ascend to the throne, cautiously, to induct into royalty, hence, implication, to take counsel, consult, indeed, be, make, set a, set up, king, be, make, queen, began to, make to, reigning, rule, surety, surely. The Torah testifies. Genesis chapter 14, verse 18. And Melchizedek, king of Salem, brought forth bread and wine, and he was the priest of the Most High Yah. Come on now. The prophets proclaim. Isaiah chapter 44, verse 6. Thus says the Most High, the King of Israel, and his Redeemer, the Most High of hosts. I am the first, and I am the last. And besides me, there is no God. I know that's right. The writings bear witness. Psalms chapter 10, verse 16. The Most High is King forever and ever. The heathens are perished out of his land. We have completed the Mephistala study this morning, reviewing King. First, we recognize the standard set in the Torah in 613 principles. Then we search the witnesses in the books of the prophets, the Nevi'ims, and the books of the writings, the Ketuvims. Collectively, the Torah, the Nevi'ims, and the Ketuvims, or identified as the Tanakh, which is the Old Testament's proper title, and is the only book that Yahushua studied in reference throughout the New Testament. 5 a.m. prayer. The Most High Yah is our King. And we must understand that a king is opposite from a president. We live in a modern day Babylon, which is a democracy, which is not the way the Most High Yah established us to live. We are in this world, but not of this world. Until we change our mindset to the original mindset of the Most High Yah that he established, we will never fully operate the way we should. Hosea chapter 13, verse 10. I will be thou king. Where is any other that may save thee in all thou cities? And thou judgest of whom thou sayest. Give me a king and princes. Shalom Aleichem. Peace be unto you, 5 a.m. prayer community. The Most High Yah is coming to change our mindsets permanently, which is going to take application from all of the knowledge that the Most High has given us. So now, are you ready for the word of Yah, the father of Abraham, the father of Isaac, the father of Jacob? Are you ready for the word of Yah, the father of Abraham, the father of Isaac, the father of Jacob? This morning, we are coming out of the book of Exodus. Exodus chapter 20 in its entirety. You should know it by now. You should know it by now. See, this comes with application. When you keep reapplying until this thing takes root and you begin to walk in it. Exodus chapter 20 in its entirety. And it reads, and Yah spake all these words saying, I am the Most High, thou Yah, which have brought thee out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of bondage. Thou shalt have no other gods before me. Thou shalt not make unto thee any graven image or any likeness of anything that is in heaven above, or that is in the earth beneath, or that is in the water under the earth. Thou shalt not bow down thyself to them, nor serve them. For I am the Most High, thou Yah, am a jealous Yah, visiting the iniquity of the fathers upon the children unto the third and fourth generations of them that hate me, and showing mercy unto thousands of them that love me and keep my commandments. Thou shalt not take the name of the Most High, thou Yah, in vain. For the Most High Yah will not hold him guiltless that taketh his name in vain. Remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. 6 days shall thou labor and do all thy work, but the seventh day is the Sabbath of the Most High, thou Yah. In it thou shalt not do any work, thou, nor thou son, nor thou daughter, thou manservant, nor thou maidservant, nor thou cattle, nor thou stranger that is within thou gates. For in 6 days the Most High made heaven and earth, the sea, and all that is in them, and he rested the seventh day. Wherefore the Most High blessed the Sabbath day and hallowed it. Honor thou father and thou mother, that thou days may be long upon the land which the Most High thou Yah giveth thee. Thou shalt not kill. Thou shalt not commit adultery. Thou shalt not steal. Thou shalt not bear false witness against thou neighbor. Thou shalt not covet thou neighbor's house. Thou shalt not covet thou neighbor's wife, nor his manservant, nor his maidservant, nor his ox, nor his ass, nor anything that is thou neighbor's. And all the people saw the thundering and the lightning and the noise of the shofar and the mountain smoking. And when they saw it, they removed and stood afar off. And they said unto Moshe, speak thou with us and we will hear. But let not Yah speak with us lest we die. Moses said unto the people, fear not, for Yah is come to prove you. And that his fear may be before your faces that ye sin not. And the people stood afar off, and Moses drew near unto the thick darkness where Yah was. And the Most High Yah said unto Moses, thus thou shalt say unto the children of Israel, ye have seen that I have talked with you from heaven. Ye shall not make with me gods of silver, neither shall you make unto you gods of gold. An altar of earth thou shalt make unto me, and thou shalt sacrifice thereon thou burnt offerings and thou peace offering, thou sheep and thou oxen, and all the places where I record my name. I will come unto thee and I will bless thee. And if thou will make me an altar of stone, thou shalt not make it of hewn stone. For if thou lift up thou two to upon it, thou hast polluted it. Neither shall thou go up by steps unto my altar, that thou nakedness be discovered thereon. I am the Most High Yah. May the Most High Yah add a blessing to the reading and hearing of his most holy word. Understanding the kingdom concepts. What you say? Understanding the kingdom concepts. The message of the Bible is about a king, a kingdom, and his royal offsprings. Come on and get some understanding this morning. Understanding the kingdom concepts. The message of the Bible is about a king, a kingdom, and his royal offspring. Every one of the 7 billion people on planet Earth is seeking the kingdom of the Most High Yah, which is their ultimate fulfillment. Every religion and activity of mankind is man's attempt to find the kingdom. Come on now, we're reviewing some things right now. You should have this already deep down in your soul. It is the ultimate fulfillment. Every religion and activity of mankind is a man's attempt to find the kingdom. It is the pearl that outvalues all pearls, and the only treasure that is worth all the other treasures of life. The kingdom is life itself. Therefore, it is imperative, crucial, and necessary that we understand the concepts of kingdoms so that we can better appreciate the good news brought to earth by our Most High and Creator. All true kingdoms contain the same characteristics and components. Here are concepts and principles of kingdoms that you should know and become familiar with. Study and apply them to the message of the kingdom of the Most High Yah and heaven taught by the King himself, Yahushua HaMashiach. In order to fully understand your purpose, potential, power, and position in life. The Most High Yah's simple strategy for extending and establishing his kingdom on this earth was to rule the visible world of man from the invisible realm of spirit. Say it again. The Most Yah's simple strategy for extending and establishing his kingdom on this earth was to rule the visible world of man from the invisible realm of the spirit. The plan meant that man would be his visible representative, created specifically to live in the visible realm to represent him. Let me put it another way. The Most High Yah's original purpose and intent was to rule that which is seen, the visible world, through that which is unseen, the invisible world. He would do this through the unseen, the spirit of the Most High Yah in man, living in the unseen spirit of man and living in the seen, the physical body, on the seen, the earth. You better shut up. For since the creation of the world, his invisible attributes His eternal power and divine nature have been clearly seen, being understood through what has been made, so that they are without excuse. Romans chapter 1, verse 20. I'm going to read that again. For since the creation of the world, his invisible attributes, his eternal power and divine nature have been clearly seen, being understood through what was made, so that they are without excuse. Romans chapter 1, verse 20. For by him all things were created, both in the heavens and on earth, visible and invisible, whether thrones or dominions or rulers or authorities. All things have been created through him and for him. Colossians chapter 1, verse 16. By faith we understand that the worlds were prepared by the word of the Most High Yah, so that what was seen was not made out of things which are visible. Hebrews chapter 11, verse 3. How would he accomplish this? The Most High Yah, who is unseen, would put his spirit into the unseen spirit of man, a spirit inhabiting a visible physical body living on the visible earth. Through man's spirit, a window of the soul is created so that man can communicate with the invisible world of the Most High Yah. And also through another window, man is able to communicate through his body to the visible world of man. Man is created in such a powerful and unique way that he is exalted above all of the Most High Yah's creation. By this means, the Most High Yah could communicate from the unseen realm through the unseen spirit, man, to the seen realm, so that the visible world of man could understand his will. Y'all better come on this morning. Whatever the Most High Yah desired would be relayed to the unseen, then manifested in the seen, on the scene, so that the earth would show what heaven was thinking. Come on, Most High Yah. Number one, the kingdom principle of kings. The king is the central component of a kingdom and embodies the essence of the kingdom. Say that again, Dr. J. Number one, the kingdom principle of kings. The king is the central component of a kingdom and embodies the essence of the kingdom. The king is the ultimate source of authority in the kingdom, and through this authority establishes the kingdom. The sovereignty of the king is inherent in his royal authority. Here are some unique qualities about a king. Number one, a king is never voted to power. Y'all better come on and go with me this morning. A king is never voted into power. Number two, a king's authority is by birthright. I got the rights because I was born. I'm the seed of Abraham. Number three, a king cannot be voted out of power. What you say? Number four, a king's word is a law in his territory. Number five, a king's personally owns everything in his domain. Number six, a decree of the king is unchanging. Say that again, Dr. J. A decree of the king is unchanging. Number six, the king chooses who will be a citizen of his kingdom. Number seven, the king embodies the government of his kingdom. Number eight, the presence of the king is the presence of his entire kingdom authority. Number eight, the king measures his wealth by the wealth of his property. Number 9, the home of the king expresses his nature, and the name of the king is the essence of his power. Woo! Therefore, the kingdom of heaven is like a king who wanted to settle accounts with his servants. Matthew chapter 18, verse 23. Say to the daughters of Zion, see, your king comes to you, gentle and riding on a donkey, on a colt, the foal of a donkey. Matthew chapter 21, verse 5. The kingdom of heaven is like a king who prepared a wedding banquet for his son. Matthew chapter 22, verse 2. You are a king then, said Pilate. Yahushua answered, you are right in saying, I am a king. In fact, for this reason I was born, and for this I came into the world, to testify to the truth. Everyone on the side of truth, listen to me. John chapter 18, verse 37. Now the king, eternal, immortal, invisible, the only most high Yah, be honor and glory forever and ever. 1 Timothy chapter 1, verse 17. They will make war against the Lamb. Come on, Most High Yah. They will make war against the Lamb, but the Lamb will overcome them, because he is Lord of lords and King of kings, and with him will be he called chosen and faithful followers. Revelations chapter 17, verse 14. Number 2, the kingdom lordship principle. All true kings must have property or a domain over which they exercise rulership of dominion. Therefore, all true kings are personally legal owners of property, territory, or their domain. Another word for owner is lord. All true kings are automatically lords. Kings own all that is in their domain. Kings rule or command whatever is in their property or domain. Kings have absolute authority and control over their property. The king's wealth is measured by the wealth of his property. Kings can give their property to anyone they wish. The earth is the Most High's, and everything in it, the world and all who live in it. For he founded it upon the seas and established it upon the waters. Psalms chapter 24, verse 1 through 3. How awesome is the Most High, the great king over all the earth. Psalms chapter 47, verse 2. That if I confess with your mouth, that if you confess with your mouth, Yahushua is Lord, and believe in your heart that the Most High Yah raised him from the dead, you will be saved. Romans chapter 10, verse 9 and 10. And every tongue confesses that Yahushua HaMashiach is Lord, to the glory of the Most High Yah, the Father. Philippians chapter 2, verse 11. Number 3, the kingdom domain principle. The domain of a king is the territory over which he exercises authority, control, and dominion. The king owns his domain and can expand or extend it by the power of his might. The wealth of the domain determines the king's glory. When the king impacts the domain with his influence, it is called his kingdom. King, domain. Woo! The king can delegate authority to others to share in the governing and administration of his domain. His dominion is an eternal dominion. His kingdom endures from generation to generation. All the people of the earth are regarded as nothing. He does as he pleases with the power of heaven and the people of the earth. No one can hold back his hand or say to him, "What have you done?" Daniel chapter 4, verse 34 and 35. Number 4, the kingdom constitution principle. You better come on in here because we have a constitution. Number 4, the kingdom constitution principle. The constitution of the kingdom is the documented will, intent, desires, and purpose of the king for his citizens and kingdom. Since a king's word is supreme, who can say to him, "What are you doing?" Whatever obeys or whoever obeys his command will come to no harm, and the wise heart will know the proper time and the procedure. What you say? That's the word, Dr. J. Since a king's word is supreme, who can say to him, "What are you doing?" Whoever obeys his commands will come to no harm, and the wise heart will know the proper time and procedure. Ecclesiastes chapter 8, verse 4 through 5. I delight in your decrees. I will not neglect your word. Psalms chapter 119, verse 16. Your word, O Most High, is eternal. It stands firm in the heavens. Your faithfulness continues through all generations. You establish the earth and it endures. Your laws endure to this day, for all things serve you. If your law has not been my delight, I would have perished in my afflictions. I will never forget your precepts, for by them you have preserved my life. Psalms chapter 119, verse 89 through 93. Let's read that one again. Your word, O Most High, is eternal. It stands firm in the heavens. Your faithfulness continues through all generations. You establish the earth and it endures. Your laws endure to this day. For all things serve you. If your law had not been my delight, I would have perished in my affliction. I will never forget your precepts, for by them you have preserved my life. Psalms chapter 119, verse 89 through 93. Yahushua answered, "It is written, man does not live on bread alone, but on every word that comes from the mouth of the Most High Yah." Matthew chapter 4, verse 4. Number 5, the kingdom law principle. What you say? The kingdom law principle. The law of the kingdom is proclaimed, is the proclaimed word, decrees, and edicts of the king. And these laws determine the standards and precepts by which the kingdom is to be governed. I'm going to sit that right there for 1 second. Mm-hmm. You're not under the law, you got grace. Well, that's why you're not in the kingdom, you're in a religion. Number 5. the kingdom law principle. The law of the kingdom is the proclaimed word, decrees, and edicts of the king. And these laws determine the standards and precepts by which the kingdom is to be governed. And if we are careful to obey all this law before the Most High, our Most High Yah, as he has commanded us, that will be our righteousness. Ooh, this is so good. If you don't break down the principle of the law in the kingdom, and if we are careful to obey all this law before the Most High, our Most High Yah, as he has commanded us, that will be our righteousness. Deuteronomy chapter 6, verse 25. The law of the Most High is perfect, reviving the soul. Ooh, anybody need a soul revival? The law of the Most High is perfect, reviving the soul. Ooh, you better come on, Holy Ghost. The statutes of the Most High are trustworthy, making wise the simple. The precepts of the Most High are right, giving joy to the heart. Ooh, child. The commands of the Most High are radiant, giving light to the eyes. Ooh. Psalms chapter 19, verse 7 and 8. The law from your mouth is more precious to me than thousands of pieces of silver and gold. Ooh, what'd you say? The law of your mouth is more precious to me than thousands of pieces of silver and gold. Psalms chapter 119, verse 72. I tell you the truth, until heaven and earth disappear, not the smallest letter, not the least stroke of a pen will by any means disappear from the law until everything is accomplished. Where your pastor at? Where your pastor at? This scripture right here, Matthew chapter 5, verse 18, this verse tells you right here, the law ain't been done away with. I tell you the truth, until heaven and earth disappear, not the smallest letter, not the least stroke of a pen will by any means disappear from the law until everything is accomplished. Child. Ooh, Matthew chapter 5, verse 18. Come on, Queen Adrian. Come on, girl. Number 6, the kingdom keys principle. Ooh, let me tell you one thing. That teaching on Sabbath taught about the keys. The kingdom keys principle. The keys of the kingdom are the principles, precepts, laws, and systems by which the kingdom functions. Say it again, Dr. J. Oh my goodness, my soul. I done found an anchor for myself. The kingdom keys principle. The keys of the kingdom are the principles, precepts, laws, and systems by which the government functions. You've been dysfunctional. Come on in here so you can function now. Let me give you some keys. The keys must be learned and applied by the citizens in order to appropriate the benefits and privileges of the kingdom. I will give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven. Whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven. And whatever you loose on earth will be loosed in heaven. Matthew chapter 16, verse 19. Principle number 7 about the kingdom. The kingdom citizenship principle. Ooh, they about to talk about you. The kingdom citizenship principle. Citizenship in a kingdom is not a right, but a privilege. And it is at the pleasure of the king himself. Come on now, King of Kings and Lord of Lords. The kingdom citizen principle. Citizenship in a kingdom is not a right, but a privilege. And it is at the pleasure of the king himself. Citizens are chosen by the king and are beneficiaries of the king's pleasure and promises. Ooh, child. But our citizenship is in heaven, and we eagerly await a savior from there. The Most High, Yeshua HaMashiach, who by the power that enables him to bring everything under his control, will transform our lowly bodies so that they will be like his glorious body. Ooh, shut up now. Philippians chapter 3, verse 20 and 21. Yahushua was said, my kingdom is not of this world. If it were, my servants would fight to prevent my arrest by the Jews. But now, my kingdom is from another place. John chapter 18, verse 36. But he continued, you are from below. I am from above. You are of this world. I am not of this world. John chapter 8, verse 23. They are not of the world, even as I am not of it. Oh, he talking about you? John chapter 17, verse 16. Y'all need to be going crazy this morning. You are citizens of the kingdom. And he's handing out principles this morning. Number 8, the kingdom royal privilege principle. Ooh, child. Come on, Holy Ghost. Number 8, the kingdom royal privilege principle. Royal privileges of the kingdom are the benefits the king affords his citizens. Why we be running around here acting like we broke? The Most High Yah shall supply all our needs according to his riches and glory and according to principle number 8 of the kingdom. The kingdom royal privilege principle. Royal privileges of the kingdom are the benefits the king affords his citizens. They serve as a security for being in good standing with the king. Are you in good standing with the king? I know I am. But seek first his kingdom and his righteousness, and all these things will be given to you as well. Therefore, do not worry about tomorrow. What you say, Most High? But seek first his kingdom and his righteousness, and all these things will be given to you as well. Therefore, Do not worry about tomorrow. Matthew chapter 6, verse 33 and 34. And my, the Most High, will meet all your needs according to his glorious. Woo, I left that little part out. You know, we always talk about according to his riches and glory. Now, child, you got to read the word line upon line, precept upon precept. This changes everything about your circumstances. And my, the Most High, will meet all your needs according to his glorious riches. And Hamashiach Yahushua. Philippians chapter 4, verse 19. Principle number 9 about the kingdom. The kingdom code of ethics principle. What you say? Number 9. The kingdom code of ethic principle. This is the standard of the conduct established by the king for the behavior and social relationships of his citizens. Where your conduct at? Because your confession should match your conduct. Number 9. The kingdom code of ethics principle. This is the standard of conduct established by the king for the behavior and social relationships of his kingdom. And we're going to stop here. This is also the expectation of the king regarding the values and moral standards the citizens must adhere to. The code of ethics becomes the foundation of the kingdom culture and manifests itself in the lifestyle of the citizens. Do you know that the wicked will not inherit the kingdom of the Most High Yah? Do not be deceived. Neither the sexually immoral, nor idolaters, nor adulterers, nor male prostitutes, nor homosexual offenders, nor thieves, nor the greedy, nor the drunkards, nor the slanders, nor the swindlers will inherit the kingdom of the Most High Yah. And that is what some of you were. Ooh. But you were washed. You were sanctified. You were justified in the name of the Most High, Yahushua HaMashiach, and by the Spirit of our, the Most High Yah. 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 9 through 11. Ooh, many are called, but few are chosen. Many are called, but few are chosen. Did he not just tell you what you were? Let me read that again. Okay, this is the scripture. Do you not know that the wicked will not inherit the kingdom of the Most High Yah? Now he's saying, do not be deceived. Neither the sexually immoral, nor idolaters, nor adulterers, nor male prostitutes, nor homosexual offenders, nor thieves, nor the greedy, nor the drunkards, nor the slanderers. You better stop slandering folks. Nor swindlers, and swindling folks out of their stuff, will inherit the kingdom of the Most High Yah. And that is what some of you were. Say it again, Dr. Chet. And that is what some of you were. But you were washed. Wash the Most High. You were sanctified. You were justified in the name of the Lord, Yahushua HaMashiach, and by the Spirit of our Most High Yah. 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 9 through 11. All praises to the Most High Yah. Whew. I know what you mean when you say, whew, thank the Most High Yah ain't what I used to be. Now, I know I'm not what I ought to be, but thank him I'm not what I used to be. Here are your next five principles under the eighth commandment, thou shalt not steal. Principle number 480. You shall not reap the corners of your field and the gleaning of your harvest. Leviticus chapter 23, verse 22. Principle number 481. You shall not aggrieve one another in your buying and selling. Leviticus chapter 25, verse 14. Principle number 482. You shall not give your brother your money for interest. Y'all be letting folks borrow money and put interest on it. I know I gave you 20 bucks, but I'm going to need back 50. Okay. Principle number 483. You shall not give your brother. You shall not give your brother food for increase. Ooh. Leviticus chapter 25, verse 37. And principle number 484. You shall observe laws of inheritance. Numbers chapter 27, verse 8. All praises to the Most High Yah. All praises to the Most High Yah. Kingdom principles for kingdom living. Let's go.
Yeah.
Pastor Jay. Don't start no stuff, won't be no stuff. Hallelujah. That was so good. That was so good. Did y'all see the scriptures to back it up? It's nothing like being taught by the word of the Most High, y'all. Come on, y'all. The word spoke this morning. Line upon line. Precept upon precept. Heck, I'm going to need y'all to give some pastors that little scripture, that little verse in Matthew chapter 5, verse 18. I tell you the truth. I tell you the truth. Not one stroke of the pen. Not the least, the smallest letter. What'd you say? Until all the law is established. How did we miss that verse in the scripture? Now, how did we sit there and let somebody tell us we were not under the law? And Matthew chapter 5, verse 18 was sitting right there. Did we read it? We read that thing with no understanding. We was looking at the person that was giving the word instead of reading the word. We read it with no understanding. Come on, King Raynard. Truly the Most High Yah. He spoke this morning. Amazing. Y'all, the scales are falling off our eyes. We are sure enough coming out of darkness into his marvelous light. I'm trying to tell you, he's so good. Let me tell you another thing. When y'all get some time, sit down and listen to Sabbath teaching. Understanding the keys of the kingdom, it will blow your mind. It's so good that the Most High Yah is saying to me, that may be an encore performance. That teaching was off the chain. When you get a chance, sit down and listen to Sabbath teaching. It will blow your mind. Understanding the keys of the kingdom. Because if you don't understand the keys of the kingdom, you can't lock up nothing. You can't unlock nothing. You can't close something. You can't open something. You can't loose something and you can't unloose it. You cannot miss that part of this kingdom series. There's no way. You cannot miss that teaching from Sabbath. You have to go back and listen to it. I'm like the Holy Spirit is talking to all of us right now. Even if you were there on Sabbath, go back and listen to that teaching again because it gives so much understanding about this whole kingdom series. You can't miss that piece of the puzzle. It is so important that all these pieces of the puzzle that the Most High Yah is teaching, that you get them. You got to get them. You can't miss any of the series. You just can't miss it. That's why I'm so glad it's recorded, that you can always go back and listen. You can listen on YouTube. You can listen on Facebook. You can always go back and get this word again. Sabbath teaching, just off the chain. Just off the chain. It was so good. Understanding the keys of the kingdom. Whew. Get ready, queens. Get ready. Because this Sabbath, we start our relationship series about the kingdom. And we're coming with the women first. Understanding the purpose and power of woman. So this Sabbath, we're going to be teaching on that. Y'all ready, queens? Because some things we don't understand about ourselves the way the Most High Yah made us. And so we don't know how to operate, you know, functionally in relationships. And so that's the reason our relationships sometimes fall apart, because we never knew how to operate in relationships. So the Most High Yah is about to give the key to the women. And then after we finish this series on the women, then we're going to go to understanding the man. We about to get another key. He's giving out keys, y'all. But you got to be willing to get these keys and use them. Okay? King Raynard said, I'm so concerned with those of my church family that continue the traditions. It's beautiful coming into the awakening. I'm concerned too, King Raynard, because my family, I'm sitting up here teaching. Well, they can sit down and be taught. And any questions they need answered, they can get answered by the Most High Yah through me. I ain't saying I know everything, but I can study that thing out. So, and they still celebrating Christmas. They still doing these pagan things. They still worshiping on Sunday. They just have not got the revelation. They still sleep. So Judah has to wake them up. Just like Prophet Wilkins was teaching last night. Bless him and First Lady Charnette. The awakening starts through Judah. Nothing happens until Judah wakes up. And Judah's so asleep right now, we got to shake them so hard. Wake up, Judah. Wake up. Nothing happens. Y'all need to pay attention. Until Judah. We are Judah. Nothing happens until all of Judah wakes up. You got to wake up. That's the bottom line. We got to wake up and we got to stay woke. Stay woke. We got to stay woke. So I'm thankful to the Most High Yah, how he's teaching us. And I mean teaching us. Yes. And like I said, we got to be nice, y'all. With love and kindness have the Most High drawn us. So we have to be nice and we have to teach them. This is the reason why we do what we do. And we can take them straight to the scripture. So that's why I'm glad the Most High Yah always have me to teach what we're doing. We're going to teach on Hanukkah. We're going to teach on the menorah. And I hope you guys are ordering your menorahs off of Amazon and your candles and getting ready to light it up, because we are the light of the world. We're going to teach on the menorah. We're going to teach on Christmas, where it came from, the origins. We're going to teach on Santa Claus like we did last year. We're going to teach on the origins of what things can come from so we can come out of darkness into his marvelous light. So, yes. All right. Erica said, I do. So, Erica got her menorah. So, yeah, you can get them on Amazon. I think they're like, some of them are $20. It just depends how elaborate you want to get. Some of them are cheaper than that. I found them at Target. They're at Target, too. Just so you know, you can go online. I'm going to tell you again, you better not be in nobody's store. You can go online and you can order your menorah and your candles. Target has it. I got some great ones from Target last year. I think I only paid like $10 for them. They were not expensive at all. Oh, please invite your sister-in-law and your brother to some of these teachings. It would be so good. It's an awakening. Because if they don't know, they're stuck in traditions. And I don't want to say like they're stuck in traditions. It's just that they don't know. They haven't been taught. So we can't like crucify folks that ain't been taught. We got to give it to them. And if they decide to get the teaching and then still be like, I'm still going to do Christmas, then that's on them. You know, the Most High going to be like, I'm going to deal with them. Don't you worry about it. Just make it available. And that's what we need to do. Just make the word available. That's it. So continue to pray for Prophet Keith Wilkins and First Lady Charnette. He had walking pneumonia for a month or two. Prophet Keith Wilkins has been very sick. So y'all keep lifting them up in prayer and sending Raphael. And First Lady Charnette, she had surgery. So you keep praying for her. Keep them in your prayers. I'm always lifting them up. And I'm always lifting you guys up. Queen Adrian and Queen Erica and Queen Evelyn and Queen Regina. Queen Doreen. I'm always lifting you guys up in prayer. We have to pray for one another. Auntie, what kind of candles? When you go on Amazon, just put in Hanukkah candles in the search. And the Hanukkah candles will come up. There are so many different beautiful candles that you can get. You know, your auntie has got the OCD. She got them all. Chad, I'm candle. I was like, get that one too, and that one too. Did we get like 6 boxes of candles? They like, we don't need all them candles, but whatever. So yeah. So y'all keep praying. We pray for one another. Lift them up, Pastor Davis. Lift him up, Pastor Gillette. Lift them up. The sons of Yah, keep them in prayer, because, you know, they're going to be doing some awesome, mighty things. And just send healing every time you think about it. Send Raphael to King Stefan house. Send Raphael to King Reynard house. Just keep sending Raphael, because some of us do have to go out. And so we want that shield of protection around us when we go out. Oh, look at that, Queen Adrian. She said, I got a lot of Hanukkah candles in my cart. I'm just waiting on the blessing. I know that's right, Queen Adrian. And the Most High Yah is going to bless you. Trust and believe. So I'm thankful to the Most High. Yes. Thank you. All right. What an awesome morning. Oh, what an awesome morning. I'm so excited about us teaching the purpose and power of the woman. I'm so excited. I want to be taught. I just love what the Most High is doing with relationships. Because we have to be taught about relationships. Our relationship with Him first, as we walking through this kingdom, and then our relationship with one another. Those are the commandments. Those are the Ten Commandments with the principles under them. So, yes. So, all right then. May the Most High Yah bless you and keep you. May the Most High Yah make His face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Most High Yah lift up His countenance upon you and give you His peace. So they shall put my name on the children of Israel, and I will bless them. All praises to the Most High Yah. So get to the blog spot, get to Facebook, get to YouTube. It will encourage you. Have a supernatural day 3. This is a day of divine intervention, y'all. Divine intervention. I love you, love you, love you. Oh, I love you. You know I love you. Bye now. So good. So good. Bless you, King Reynard. Bless you. Bless you.